Children, you're welcome to yet another session. We are in here again for social studies. We shall start with the activity for lesson 4 and 5. I'll be reading from this piece as we proceed forth. I start. Number 1. Give reasons why African kings and chiefs supported slave trade, yet it was evil. True, we saw that slavery was evil, went through the evils, but why would it support it? Quite many solutions. One, slave trade made kings and chiefs rich. Slave trade helped kings and chiefs get new items of trade. Slave trade helped kings and chiefs get guns. Why were these guns special in this way? Guns were used for developing their kingdoms, for expanding their kingdoms. So, given those three items, true, kings and chiefs in Africa supported the slave trade, yet it was evil. Number 2, how did slave trade lead to development of kingdoms in Africa? How did slave trade lead to development of kingdoms in Africa? We're going to answer based on guns. One, guns that were got through slave trade were used to develop or expand kingdoms. African kings and chiefs got guns that were used to develop or expand their kingdoms. Number 3, mention ancient methods that were used to obtain slaves. Remember, we said the meaning of the word obtain can as well be get. So, how were slaves got at that time? Many items deal. One, through raids, through capturing people in lonely places, through barter system or exchange. In our meaning, some traders would exchange goods for slaves. We would also accept that through fueling or through supporting inter-tribal wars. These same traders will support one tribe against the other. But how they get, how they benefit? The captives of war will be sold to the traders. So, through fueling or through supporting inter-tribal wars. Number 4. Why were Christian missionaries hated by Arab traders in Africa? In this question, we are having two parties. The Christian missionaries and also the Arab traders. These two parties were never consenting. They were at all times parallel. Why? Christian missionaries reported the evils of slave trade. Therefore, they were hated by Arabs for Arab traders. Equally, can say Christian missionaries were fighting against slave trade. So, since the Arabs were benefiting from slave trade, and in here, the exceptions were fighting against it, there is no way they will be at the same footing. Next question is number 5. Name the largest slave market in Africa. Could as well be name the largest island slave market in Africa. It will remain Zanzibar. Number 6. How were slaves important to Arab traders during long distance trade? How were slaves important to Arab traders during long distance trade? Remember, we said long distance trade is just as caravan trade. So, how were slaves important to those traders? Item 1. Slaves were items of trade to long distance traders. Children, them were saying, one, slaves were items of trade to long distance traders. Number 2, slaves were used to carry loads or heavy loads by the Arab traders. Same as Arab traders use slaves to carry goods or to carry items of trade. Next question is number 7. Children, number 7 is, why did the number of elephants reduce during long distance trade or during caravan trade? Why did the number of elephants reduce? One, Ugandans were killed to obtain ivory. How to call the difference between ivory and the elephant tusks? Before they pick off the tusk, before they break off the tusk, become ivory, they must kill that elephant. Remember, an elephant can't accept to break off its tusk as they are waiting. You must come with it, after you must kill it. So many elephants were killed in the advent of getting ivory. Next question is, in which way did the slave trade lead to famine in Africa? Same as how the slave trade lead to famine in Africa. Item one, slave traders took many able-bodied Africans who would offer labor in gardens. It's the same reason as Africa, there was a limited labor force in Africa due to slave trade. Next reason could be many Africans were hiding or were busy hiding for fear of slave traders. Therefore, there is no way that they would be working. Next question here is, in which way the slave trade lead to famine over Africa? That one, number nine. State two ways in which slave trade affected social development. State two ways in which slave trade affected social development. So how was slave trade a danger to social development? One, slave trade led to suffering. Suffering is a social aspect. So one, slave trade led to suffering. Two, slave trade led to famine. Slave trade led to famine. Famine is equal to a social aspect. Let's carry on. Number 10, give two reasons why it was difficult to bring slave trade an end. Before I get social with this, I want to give some caution here. That whenever we get some question that is addressing two questions, or is asking for one question, please get to that same aspect. If you want one question, one answer, give one answer. If it's two answers, please give two answers. This one wants two answers. Give reasons why it was difficult to bring slave trade to an end. What do you think are the reasons here? One, slave trade was highly profitable. Remember, when an item is highly valuable and highly profitable, it's difficult to bring to an end of that trade. That's why illegal trade still continues. Reason, it's highly profitable. Number two, slave traders had many trade routes. Next, slave traders were using or covering a large area. Slave trade covered a large area. The other aspect is, slave trade was beneficial to kings and chiefs. Slave trade was highly beneficial to kings and chiefs, same as kings and chiefs benefited from slave trade. Children, that is the end aspect of our questions. I hope you have had some self-check. So we shall pick on from there. I want to get on this board now. Last time we talked about triangular trade, that is also called transatlantic trade. We talked about triangular trade, that is also called transatlantic trade. We talked of three continents that were in play as far as that's concerned. I want to pick the continents here and we proceed forward. One was Europe, permit me to put our Europe here. Two was Africa, I'm putting our Africa here. And three was America, permit me to put our America here. And I'm placing these continents in correspondence with their direction from the other. I hope you call as well to topic one, location of Africa. We went through location of Africa from other countries and so forth. So remember the routes. One, we had a route from Africa to Europe, to America. A route from Africa, America, that we left. Also a route from America to Europe, that we left. Look at the arrow. The arrow is indicating where the route was going towards. Also from Africa to Europe. Those are three routes so far. I can name them or label them. Label this route 1, label this route 2, and label this route 3. We shall introduce our key somewhere here. In the key, we shall discover that arrow number 2, perhaps second one, number 1 is from America to Europe. It is transporting agricultural raw materials. Transporting agricultural raw materials. So route 1, this route 1 was transporting agricultural raw materials. We shall see those raw materials in the next split here. Yeah? Number 2 was a route from Africa to America. This number 2 route from Africa to America was transporting one major item, that is slaves. While route 3 was transporting raw materials. Was transporting raw materials from Africa. Now, I want to introduce another route. I'll use yellow to introduce another route. Route 4, I'll indicate here like this. From Europe, Africa. Equally, route 5, I'll introduce it here like this. From Europe, America. Look at the similarity or the similarities between this route 4, and route 5. What? Both routes originate from Europe, like this one, Europe, Africa, Europe, America. Item 2, how are they similar? Both routes transport finished goods. So we are indicating here that route 4 and 5, they are having finished goods. So let's remember that we had 5 routes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Route 1 and 3 have some similarity. How is route 1 similar to route 3? Both transport raw materials. The other reason is both are led towards Europe. How is route 5 similar to route 4? Both come from Europe as number 1 and 2. Both transport finished goods. You can as well say both transport industrial goods or both transport manufactured goods. Children, you want to clearly look at the goods in the next clip here. Let's look at the goods in here. Our next clip here is showing the goods. And these are pointer. The items here, the trade items or trade goods from Africa to Europe. Africa to Europe, number 3. Africa to Europe is number 3. They are transporting minerals, timber, pipes, and skins. These are also raw materials. Look at this, America to Europe. America to Europe, route 1. They are transporting cotton, tea, tobacco, sugar. Remember we said
This sugar was crude sugar. The special route 2 is from Africa, America, Africa to America, transporting one item, that is cells. This cells. So in the next aspect, children, we now want to see the effects. I hope you have picked so well. We now want to see the effects of long distance trade. So we can start off from here. We want to see effects of cell trade. Effects of long distance trade. No. Effects of transatlantic trade. Remember, we said transatlantic trade is just the same as this intercontinental trade, which is actually triangular trade because it's shaped like a triangle. What were the effects? One positive and two negative. So let's start with the positive aspects. What good things do you think came out of this trade? Quite many of them. One, Africa was known worldwide. Africa was known worldwide. Because the trade involved many continents and they come to Africa quite often to look for goods or to pick goods. So I say true. Africa was known worldwide. What is about the items? We have talked about items from Africa to America. So Africa got new items of trade. Same as new items of trade were used in Africa. New items of trade. Were introduced. I want to give this a bigger reasoning that much as goods were taken to all those continents, so every continent was anticipating new items of trade. New items of trade would be got in Africa, equally, new items of trade would be got in America. This applies to Europe. So that's very true. The other positive aspect is led to development of kingdoms. Yes, I've just said in the other corrections that African leaders loved these traders in that the guns introduced were used to develop their kingdoms or expand their kingdoms, also to protect their people or their citizens. The other issue is African kings and chiefs got new items of trade. African kings and kings got new items of trade. Same as new goods. New items of trade, same as new goods. Remember, we're talking about new items here, referring to the continents, but here we're referring to the kings themselves. The other aspect is the development of kingdoms. These are positive aspects. Why would we say that transatlantic trade was good? These are the considerations. We now want also to see the negative ones. Why would we say that transatlantic trade was bad, was dangerous, was harmful? Let's see the dangers of transatlantic trade by saying negative. What were the negative outcomes? One, depopulation. There was depopulation in Africa. When we say Africa was basically
kept talking in terms of West Africa. So we said the route that was taking slaves from Africa, America, was very active. Very many children of Africa left the continent for Europe, I mean for America, not willing. They took them against their will, so we're saying it led to depopulation in Africa. Remember, depopulation has many things that follow, such as led to famine. Because we've taken all our most of our able-bodied people, our strong people, it means the energy force, the labor force, the workers, the workforce has reduced in Africa. Therefore, very many people were having repeated occurrences of famine because of this fate here. We have another aspect here that's about resources. Loss of African resources. I'm calling it loss of resources. One might look at it as though it was proper trade, but Africans never knew the value of what they had. They thought what they had was so cheap. So in this trade, people who were trading from Africa, they were actually benefiting. So we're saying it's true that Africa lost resources. Loss of led to death. Loss or death of many animals. Remember, we said animals that have nice skins and hides were killed, and those hides and skins were exported. Also, because elephants. Many elephants were killed for their tusks or for the great ivory. So we're saying the negative aspects of transatlantic trade include depopulation, famine, loss of resources, and death of many animals. Children, I want to think that we have learned quite many things. We shall proceed forth with an activity from the same subtopic, and our next subtopic will be trans-Saharan trade. Keep there when time comes. I want to wish you the very best. Stay tuned at all times. Bye for now.